16, and then, you know, passes to me, or the crossing, he's more watching. He hasn't been done on the race because he is one of those old school guys that is willing to do anything. He's lost this race in such a dramatic fashion. And so I'll keep an eye on him just for excitement purposes. But Ray Rahal, Bobby Rahal's son, been in this race since 2008. There's a lot of really quiet buzz in the gasoline alley that it might be this car.
Talking with Ryan McGee, hear him, Marty and McGee. This is Best Week Ever on ESPN Radio. Ryan's live from the Indy 500. Talked about the Euro Cross. Besides that, what's the biggest storyline at the Indy 500 today?
Well, the sport of IndyCar racing as a whole is kind of going through this huge. And we have so many guys in this race that have been around for so long. Scott Dixon, Tony Kanaan, Will Power, Helio Castroneves is here. To get his fourth Indy 500, but only three of the guys who have ever done that in the history of the race. But there's a youth movement happening. There's already been three winners this year of guys in their early 20s. And Colton Herta is starting second in this race. His dad, Brian Herta, this is where I am in my career. Now I'm covering the sons of the guys that I was covering when I first started in the sport. So I covered Brian Herta years ago, and now his son, Colton, will be starting on the front row of the Indianapolis 500. So keep an eye on Ben O'Rourke. Keep an eye on a lot of these 21, 22-year-old guys, because when you talk to the veterans, they're not ready to hand it over yet, but there's definitely a change in the guard that's happening in the sport right now.
Hey, Ryan, just on a personal level, I mean, how exhilarating is it just for you to be around this many people? I mean, to have 140,000 people there, and just to be around all of this. I mean, we had to cover football games in the fall, in the winter, where there was no one in the stands.
Yeah.
And that was so depressing. Just didn't feel right. Saying all the way back to normal, but being so much closer back to having that normal feel when your job the right way.
Well, you said it the perfect way. It's not all the way back, and it's hard to remember that because we get so excited. But you know, this thing hasn't gone away yet, and people still got to get their shots, and you still got to wear your masks. They're very adamant about that. You're listening. If you didn't get your credentials to cover this race, you didn't have your vaccination card. And no one's working in the garage that hadn't gotten their shots. And so I've got my mask on right now talking to you guys. And so it's still there, but you get there, right? This is the biggest step forward towards being normal. And for me, this is my favorite event to cover. And so sitting at home last May with nothing happening, and then sitting at home in August because you know, there was no reason to be here because you couldn't interview anybody. Sitting at home in August and watching the race in front of no one. You know, racing in front of the Indy grandstand, this feels normal. And it was really even more normal a year ago, hopefully, with a full house, 300,000 plus. But to me, it's just energy, man. You're right. I mean, I covered the ACC championship game. I got Clemson, you know, trying to win a national championship. And you know, that game was 10 minutes from my house in Charlotte. And it was like covering a scrimmage in an airplane hangar. It was a noise. And so to be here today and just see people walking through the turnstiles, and smiles on their faces. People hugging it out. I mean, it's like a family reunion. And I think a lot of stuff is going to feel like that over the next year.
Good stuff, Ryan. Well, enjoy it today. It's going to be pretty special out there. We appreciate the time.
Anytime, boys. Thanks.
That has been Straight Talk Wireless. That has been Straight Talk, I should say. I said about Straight Talk Wireless. No contract, no compromise. Big thanks to Ryan McGee, live from the Indy 500, for joining us. Of course, Ryan McGee of Marty Indy on ESPN Radio. Coming up, the Bears, Justin Fields, Andy Dalton. That's next. This is the Best Week Ever on ESPN Radio and the ESPN app.
With the 11th pick, my Chicago Bears select Justin Fields.
Let's spell a broad conversation here. His fuel is fire.
They want to get the best out of Justin Fields.
The lake is calling, so now's the time to visit Raptor Marine and ATV and move to the number one selling fishing boat, the Bass Tracker Pro Team 175 PXW with a 60 horsepower Mercury outboard. And the Bass Tracker Pro Team 175 PXW starts at only $20,995. Raptor Marine and ATV also carries Ranger aluminum bass boats. So take it from the wild, man, and pick out your new Tracker or Ranger bass boat at any of the Raptor Marine and ATV 6 statewide locations.
Are you looking for Straight Talk about retirement? benefits to retirement strategies, and each topic is designed to help you get ready for the future. Every Saturday morning, right here on 103.7 The Buzz. Some securities offered through LPL Financial Member FINRA SIPC.
Calling all anglers, registration is open for the 2021 Buzz Bass Fishing Tournament presented by Bradford Marine and ATV. Saturday, June 12th in the Arkansas River. It's your chance to compete for $6,000 in cash prizes. Register now at BigBuzzBass.com. Bradford Marine and ATV, celebrating 50 years of business.
This is Pat Bradley. Tune in every Tuesday when I join Justin and Wes in The Zone. Brought to you by River City Flooring. Visit RiverCityFlooringInc.com. RiverCityFlooringInc.com.
Yes, we've got Bear on the line. Got a question for Trey. Bear, what's your question, Trey?